Friction between different materials can cause static electricity. Liquids flowing through a pipe or being poured can create static electricity sparks, which can ignite flammable liquids with a low flash point. When working with flammable liquids, safety needs to be a priority. OSHA regulations require Category 1, 2, and Category 3 flammable liquids with a flash point below 100 degrees Fahrenheit to be bonded and grounded when dispensing from one container to another when the volumes are over 4 liters or 1 gallon. The flash point of solvents can be found on Section 9 of the safety data sheets. Bonding is the process of electrically connecting the dispensing and receiving container so that they are at equal electrical potential and will not have static spark discharge. This can be achieved using an electrically conductive bonding cable as shown. Braided wires are a good choice since they offer robust strength and dependability when frequently connected and disconnected. To achieve bonding between two metal containers, connect one end of the bonding cable to the dispensing container and the other end to the receiving container. Be sure to remove any dirt or debris from the surface and use bonding cables with strong clamps and sharp bite to ensure proper metal-to-metal connection. Although glass and plastic containers are non-conductive, the flowing flammable liquid could still generate a spark that can ignite the vapors. When dispensing to such containers, use either a metal funnel with a long stem or a conductive rod like copper immersed into the liquid as shown, which is then bonded to the dispensing container. When using a non-conductive dispensing container, it must be equipped with an approved metal suction pump and draw tube, which can then be bonded to the receiving container. Now that we have equalized any potential difference between the two containers by properly bonding them, we must safely dissipate any charge buildup to earth by grounding. For grounding, electrically connect the dispensing container to a certified grounded three-prong electrical outlet as shown. If your building has a pre-installed grounding rod or bar or cold water pipes like the ones located on the sides of a fume hood, you may ground your dispensing container to them as long as your pipe system is continuous and does not have any circuit interrupters. When your containers have been securely bonded and grounded, you may test the resistance to ensure that you have achieved proper grounding. A resistance of 1 meg ohm or less is acceptable according to the National Fire Protection Association. You may now proceed slowly with the transfer in a well-ventilated area or inside a fume hood away from heat sources and electrical equipment. A standard operating procedure for dispensing flammable solvents should be added to your group's lab safety plan. Be sure to wear appropriate eye protection, gloves, and a flame-resistant lab coat. Know the location of the closest fire extinguisher, exit, eye wash, and safety shower before proceeding with the transfer.